Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Right now, Nashua police are looking for a man they say rammed a police cruiser, nearly hitting an officer. Police say the man broke into a parked car on Pine Street yesterday afternoon. When officers approached, the suspect allegedly rammed a police car and a stolen vehicle several times to escape. The suspect was last seen on West Hollis Street driving a silver Honda Accord. Police say the suspect is a white male around 6 feet tall. He was last seen wearing a red hooded sweatshirt and a gray jacket. The man murdered in Farmington this week has been identified as 33-year-old James LaPrade. A juvenile is charged with his murder. Officers with State Police Major Crimes Unit continue to process the scene on Thursday. Farmington officers responded to 27 Oakwood Road Wednesday shortly after noon, where a man and a woman were shot. LaPrade was already dead, but the woman was taken to the hospital where she is expected to recover. On Thursday, the juvenile was arraigned in family court, where he's charged with second-degree murder and attempted murder. The AG's office also announcing that they have filed a petition with the court to have the juvenile certified as an adult. Well, new today, firefighters have saved a dozen animals after a barn in Boscawen went up in flames. The two-alarm fire broke out at around 8 this morning on High Street. Officials say some pigs, chickens, quail, and rabbits were rescued from that fire. It could be Sunday before power is restored to all customers in the Lakes region hit hard by Tuesday's nor'easter. Right now, New Hampshire Electric Co-op is reporting about 2,800 outages. 1,700 of those are in Moultonboro. Officials say the damage is a lot worse than they originally thought, which is why the work is taking so long. 2,700 athletes from around the world are competing in Austria for the Special Olympics World Winter Games this weekend, including two from right here in the Granite State. Ellie Coe of Hopkinton and Eric Lemieux of Claremont are both competing in several snowshoe events. Opening ceremonies kick off tomorrow on Saturday at 2 p.m. Starting tonight at 5, one city taking extraordinary measures to keep up with the deadly overdoses overwhelming that community. And new technology could help get rid of long lines at airport security, but will passengers be comfortable with the new approach? That does it for us, and have a great St. Patrick's Day, everybody.